Hey, good morning. What's up, internet? What's up, YouTube? It is very early, bright and early on Saturday morning. It is 5:57 in the morning, and I am headed downtown to meet up with my buddy Steve. And we are off to Quebec to a special location to shoot. We got permission from the owners of this property to take some great aerial footage of what I think is going to be a really interesting location. So I'm pretty excited about it. So off I go. I'm going to meet Steve, and then I'll see you there. Bye. All right, so we just got here. We're at the quarry. We got some really interesting fog stuff going on here. Pretty cool. But I'm not entirely sure where we're gonna fly just yet. I'm guessing we might be flying up there, perhaps. And yeah, we'll see what we got going on here. But yeah, there's some interesting, really interesting environments around. See all that fog? Oh yeah. Cool, I can't wait to get the drone out. Drive was good. It's cold though. I'm like, I should have brought a sweatshirt or something. But I didn't. Steve did though. Smart guy. So where are we gonna take off?
So you're doing this just for yourselves or?
Yeah. Yeah.
Just a bite.
Well, I have
YouTube.
We both have YouTube channels.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So I have one that's photography.
Yeah, yeah.
James has photography and vlogging.
Oh, yeah.
You know, either we do with drones or we do with cameras to take pictures, go to different sites.
So how big is your camera and your drone?
Small.
Oh, no.
Smaller.
But they're all 4K.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's high res.
Very high res. Yeah.
Amazing. Does it scare you about what people can do with these now? Yeah. I seen a guy in the States, he hooked a gun up to it.
Oh, come on.
Yeah.
You'd have to have a big one. Yeah.
Yeah, he hooked a gun up to it and he could actually fire it from an elevation.
Yeah, that's ridiculous.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, that's what scares people now, I think. That's why you guys are getting a bad rap now, because everybody's telling you that, you know, people get these and they, you know, they're flying them around airports and all kinds of ridiculous.
But it's not the tools, it's the people.
Yeah,
you know exactly. What I mean? It's the people.
It's like everything else, right?
Yeah, but, it's the people. You know?
But then there's the other side. Everybody's using for search and
but
rescue.
But you know what?
Now.
If Donald Trump gets in, we'll be able to do whatever we want.
Right.
I mean, they got the see the cable?
Yeah.
Yeah, what is that for?
That's they run from the top up there down.
Oh, it's a zipline.
Yeah, zipline.
That's cool.
Yeah, and then this guy in the boat picks them up. The zipline, what is the end? See out there in the dock?
Yeah.
That's what that dock's for right there. And they can set that. I don't know if I could do that. Not in my
age. So are these?
Yeah, and you'll see that most of the people from Montreal and stuff come down here too because of the controlled environment for diving. You see.
So where are you going to dive?
We go in over there. You go underneath this bridge.
So you're going to go in the water over there.
Yeah. You see where I put my stuff over there by the doctor?
Okay.
But a lot of people go in. Everybody goes in over there. Now, the road comes down here. And goes around and spirals down to the bottom. So, you seen a quarry before the way it spirals? Yeah. So when you go down this way, the airplane is there, the tugboat's there, and as you go down the road and around, and you come back around over to there, there's a boat over there, small boat over there. There's little submarines down here.
Yeah.
It's on the second level, so it's down at about 65 feet. It's only 30 feet here.
Uh-huh.
And as you go down, by the time you get to the tugboat, you're at 60 feet.
Okay.
And what's perfect for us, open water is to 60 feet.
Uh-huh.
So when we take them down to 60 feet, there's a thermocline. You know a thermocline?
No.
Yeah, the temperature's going to be a little different.
Colder, yeah. There's two of them in here. And that's the coolest thing, is we can show them where the thermoclines are. Like the first 30 feet, it's a certain temperature, and then you go, and it's like.
So you're really preparing them for open water.
Well, you go into a shock factor because it's cold.
Yeah.
You know, it probably changes 20 degrees.
Wow. Yeah.
And you can see people frosting up.
Uh-huh.
And when you go down to the bottom, there's another one down there. And it's, like down at the bottom of the quarry here, it's probably about, I would say 38, 39 degrees Fahrenheit.
Wow.
So it's pretty cold down there.
Yeah.
So. But like I said, the nice thing is that you'll see, we'll do all our testing over there on the other side, and then we'll bring them down, because they have to go to 60 feet. We have to let them feel the thermocline. We go over the airplane,
uh-huh.
And then we go down the road.
And how many do you have coming today? 24. 24? Yeah, 24. It'll be
24 divers. Yeah, no, it'll be more than that because you got all the instructors and helpers and dive masters.
And what time do you start? You said 7:30.
They'll be here at 7:30. They'll be coming. Watch, they'll be coming in here.
Yeah, at 7:15. Yeah.
I'm always here. I just like to be here early.
What time do you actually do the actual?
We get in the water at 8 o'clock.
That's also a nice feature. You can control the speed a little bit better.
Yeah, there's a little switch on the side.
It gives you a little bit more cinematic type, shot. All right, so Steve has got his Typhoon up there. And the sun is slowly starting to burn off quite a bit of fog that we had this morning, which is hopefully gonna give us a little bit more clarity on the water before a whole bunch of divers get in there and mess it all up. So we're gonna see what we got. Okay, so already had one phantom session. Got, I think, some really, really good shots. And now we got some scuba divers starting to get into the water now. Now that the sun's out, you can see, it's a really cool place. A lot going on. They actually have a zip line here too, so you can do some zip lining and bungee jumping, scuba diving, and some droning apparently.
It's a whole different light dynamic now, eh?
Yeah, I'm gonna try to get a shot of the jumper.
Yep.
And also they're setting up the scuba area. I think Ken here is gonna take the class and show them what's going on, where okay. They're gonna fly.
So you got your drone up, did you get to see it?
Yeah.
You can see it. You got to see it pretty good?
Yeah.
I'm going to try again.
So you got Ken, he's got a scuba diving class.
Okay, welcome to Morrison's Quarry. This used to be... Quarry actually spirals down. It goes down in a big circle, down to the bottom. And in the middle over there where they're doing bungee, it's about 130 feet in the middle there.
Okay.
And when they got down there, they realized that the water table, they hit the water table and it was coming in so bad, they looked like an artesian well. And they couldn't pump it. Mm-hmm. So they abandoned it. Now, the quarry goes down here, there's an airplane right here. Okay, we will be doing, you'll be doing your thesis. The guys behind us are running on drones. Usually you can see it crystal clear, but it's a little foggy today. That's tied off to it. And you'll do your CSIS here, okay? That's your emergency ascent. Okay, it's 30 feet. And then what we will be doing, I don't know if she's going to do it today or tomorrow. They're going to go over the boat, go over the airplane, come over down to the tug. That's your 60 foot. Most important thing at the quarry here is that you've got a lot of stuff that you can see underwater, the walls, the bottom. Keep an eye on the bottom, okay, and it'll control where you're supposed to be in the water, okay? There's another fruit cake. You see, all fruit cakes are seen. Anyways.
Thank you.
So Steve, I think it was a pretty successful outing.
Yeah, a good day of shooting.
Took a little longer to get started.
It did. Once we warmed up, and I think I'm getting sunburned now.
Yeah, me too.
The mosquitoes have burnt away.
But all in all, I think this was a really good location to shoot.
Yeah, it's great. We'll have to come back in the wintertime.
Yeah, lots of friendly people here too. So they were really nice to us.
Yeah.
So yeah, awesome.